Some of you may know this. I was once held prisoner of war for nearly 3.5 years in Chicago, Illinois. A fate worse than death, but they only had one good thing ever came out of Chicago, and that's I-65 South. But thank you. Thank you. But I gotta give Chicago credit for one thing. Chicago had great trains. You could go to Chicago and Union Station and ride a train anywhere in this country you want to go. And all my life, I'd wanted to take a train out west and see the scenery. So I went on some vacation out of Chicago, and I went down to Union Station. I bought myself a ticket on the Empire Builder, train number 5 from Chicago to Seattle, 2.5 days. And I got on the train, I got in one of those little nice little roomettes and everything. I got myself comfortable in there, and I decided to take a little walk around the train, and I walked into what another reason I love trains, the bar car. And I sat down there in a seat and began to have a cold beverage. I'd been there about 15 minutes when I looked up, and entering the bar car was one of the most lovely, enchanting looking women you've ever seen in your life. I mean, this woman was, her hair was perfect. She was dressed in look, she just walked off the cover of Vogue magazine. You don't see people like this on trains. On trains, you see people with chickens and goats, you know? People stirring pots and Mexicans coughing. I mean, that's what you see a lot on trains. I couldn't believe it. And she sits down next to me. And finally I said, ma'am, I've got to ask you, what is a woman of your obvious quality doing on a train? She said, I'm a nymphomaniac. And I have had sex in 47 of the 50 states. As a matter of fact, the only 3 I have missed will be the ones we'll be going through the next 2.5 days on the train. I said, uh-huh. Would you like to join me in a cold beverage? And she said she would, and she was obviously a woman of quality. I ordered a long neck bud. Messed around getting old Bush Bavarian for this child, you know. So we rode along together, and finally my curiosity got me. I said, ma'am, I've got to ask you this kind of question. I mean, you're obviously a woman of great knowledge and experience. What kind of men make the best lovers? She said, oh, that's easy. That's cowboys. Cowboys are fantastic in bed. That's really interesting. I said, well, who's second? She said, Jewish men. Jewish men are really fantastic in bed. That's really interesting. I made a mental note of that. We rode on for another hour or so, a few more cold beverages. And finally, you know, we're chit-chatting. She says, by the way, you've asked me all these questions. I don't know a thing in the world about you. She said, what's your name, for instance? I said, proud to meet you, ma'am. Hop along, Ginsburg, at your service. But my old man loved trains. He had a great train story. His favorite story, he must have told this a million times. This is his train story. Two brothers are on a train going north of London. And one of the brothers doesn't hear very well. Sitting across from them in a compartment is a highly decorated British officer with the mustache and all the stuff and, you know, the medals and things on his outfit. And they're riding along, and the brother can't hear too well, asks his other brother, says, ask the officer if he ever served in India. His brother says, excuse me, officer, I hate to bother you. My brother would like to know if you ever served in India. Oh, India, yes, I was in India for 27 years. India's a wonderful place. I was there with the 57th Bengal Fusiliers. What did he say? He said he was in India. They drove on. Boy, 6 up, said, ask him if he was ever in Punjab. Excuse me, officer, I hate to ask you to bother you again. My brother would like to know if you were ever in Punjab. Oh, Punjab, yes, Punjab. Wonderful place, Punjab. In Punjab for 27 years. Loved it. What'd he say? He said he was in Punjab. Right on the final line. Finally, the boy looks up and says, ask him if he ever knew a Lady Eleanor. Excuse me, officer, the last question we asked him, and I hate to bother you, but my brother would like to know, did you ever know a Lady Eleanor? Oh, Lady Eleanor. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. All the officers, men around Punjab felt that she gave the best oral sex in all of India. What'd he say? He says he knows mother.